Fair maid. I never say that to the missus. I'm Henry, by the way.
Hi.
Relief driver.
Hi.
Don't have to ask who you are. You're a big fan of mine. Oh, no, wait a minute. It's the other way around, isn't it? Honestly, what am I like?
It isn't 5:30 yet. You could have had another 3 minutes kip.
Get your head down for a while.
Seen a young man in my life before, and I've worked here 40 years.
Joe, quarter to six, Joe.
I'm up now. I've never seen the young man in my life before, and I've worked here 40 years. I've never seen the young man in my life before, and I've worked here 40 years.
Good luck, then.
Break a leg. Would you like to test me on my words? Oh, it's all right. I think I've mastered it. Got it off perfect.
You ever work with Sean? Sean Connery. Twice, mate. He's a gentleman, Sean. A scholar and a gentleman.
When I told the missus who I was picking up this morning, she said, ask her for a pair of Diamante clip-ons.
She said what?
When you had that jewellery stall.
Sorry?
In Albert Square.
Oh, God.
Do you get it?
Yes, thank you, Henry. Hilarious.
When you were in EastEnders?
Yes, I get it. That was nearly 10 years ago. I only did 4 episodes.
Best thing you've ever done. You ever work with Jim? Jim Broadbent. He's a prince among men, Jim.
Morning.
Ah, yeah. That's a nice job, are you?
Got one of my own today, believe it or not, with Amanda Holden. Drama, episode 19 of Police Siren.
Never seen it.
Tuesday night. It's very popular with the viewing public.
Tuesday night's darts night.
Speaking part, 16 words. I'll let you know when it's on.
Can't wait.
That's 3 locations for next week. We haven't even wrecked yet, Roger. I'll tell him your line producer is spitting razor blades, which I bloody am.
Morning, Leanne. You're beautiful when you're angry.
Sydney. He's never seen me spit razor blades. It's not a pretty sight.
Yes, it is.
I'm on the phone. Yes, you know I'm always on the phone. I wasn't talking to you. Now, listen.
Yes, Kelly?
Phil wants to know where's his coffee.
Mm.
On its way, he says. And Bruno, remind the caterers about his steak at lunchtime.
So, what I thought was, police car comes up, she gets out. Blah, blah, blah with the doctor. She goes to the ambulance. He does blah, blah, blah with the hospital porter. Finito. Tasty?
Love it. Knocks lap dancing into a cocked hat.
No, straight up. I know it's not Stanley Kubrick.
It's fine.
Fine for me, too.
Sorry?
Fine for sound.
Oh, right.
Just one setup, then?
Correct.
Yesterday you said you'd do three.
That was yesterday. Today's today. I've had about 2 hours sleep in between, so I thought we'd keep it nice and simple.
I was only saying.
Well, don't. You're the script supervisor. Supervise the script. Not every bloody syllable I may have uttered over the... I'm so sorry, Kelly. So sorry. 15 weeks gone, another week to go, and I'm down to my last half dozen brain cells. I'm sorry.
Phil, you're a good director, isn't he?
Saw that Bond movie last night.
Mm. Was there any cop?
Some comedian nicked my fishing rod from out the boot of my car.
And you're doing a terrific job on this, isn't he? A terrific job.
Oh!
What's wrong?
Sudden pain. tension, I expect.
Is the governor's flask ready?
Just percolating.
Yes, I think he's throwing a wobbly.
Tell me about it.
And don't forget he's putting for a steak at lunchtime.
He'll have spag bowl or cod and chips or veggie hot pot like the rest of you.
No, he wants a steak.
How about through the heart?
A Winnie Bone?
Yeah, she wants
one. Yes, Deirdre.
In case wardrobe and makeup are panicking, tell them Miss Holden will be about another 10 minutes. And I'm still one extra short.
Yeah, I'll see you later.
Hang on, this may be him. Tell them half an hour for the extras, traffic permitting.
Anything for you, Deirdre. And when I say anything...
Pratt.
Oh, sorry. I went past the bus stop practising my lines.
Name?
Deirdre Scott, second assistant, I hope.
What?
Yours.
Yours?
Oh, sorry, Joe. Joe McGill, playing the role of hospital porter, scene 23.
Right, on you get, Mr. McGill. Okay, Kevin.
She didn't. With him.
At it the whole 3 weeks. You'd think they were filming the Kama Sutra.
Miss Holden will be about 5 minutes extra, is about 20.
Cheers, Bruno.
Hello, sexy.
I thought he was gay.
Rumour hath it there was a fire alarm at the hotel in the middle of the night and they both ran out the same bedroom.
Oh, well, if they're on location, it doesn't count, does it? Not if you're playing away from home.
How can you talk about bonking at 7 o'clock in the morning?
Easy. We've been up since 4:30.
Keep still, dear.
Aye, she's a scholar and a gentleman, our Judy. Judy Dench. I'll tell you another scholar and a gentleman. You, Grant. Worked with him once. You'd get on with you, I did. Here we are, unit mates.
Do y'all need the toilet?
I beg your pardon?
Do y'all need the toilet? It's you on the Grimleys. Miss Titley, the English teacher. Remember?
Yeah.
You're always saying, do y'all need the toilet?
Yeah, thank you, Henry. It's even more hilarious.
So tell us, what happens next on EastEnders?
Jesus.
You ever work with Ian? Ian McKellen?
I have. Ian's a real prince among men.
Still feeling miserable then?
But better than yesterday, eh?
Worse.
Miss Holden, any minute, Josie. Extras on their way.
OK.
Is it something I've said? Something I've done? Something someone else has said? Or done?
We're playing first and second gossiping housewives.
Oh, yes.
Queer as Folk?
Pardon?
Were you in Queer as Folk, Channel 4?
No, I was asked, but I was up for Shakespeare in Love at the time.
Who did you play?
No one as such. I think they thought I was too young, you know, reading between the lines.
Bloody caterers.
Every bloody morning is half bloody empty!
Excuse me, Governor.
Yes, Ted.
You got a second?
For you, Ted, any time.
See, I've got this great idea for a TV series. There's these two brothers...
Ted, when I say any time, at this particular time, I'm in the middle of a shoot, for Christ's sake. You must have noticed.
Catch you later, then.
Well, I think we're doing well, all told. That's how you get BAFTA nominations, for doing crap well.
And you've had two.
And I've had two.
It's one lousy scene.
Yes! Naked!
Don't say naked, it's not nice. It's your job, you're an actress.
Out you get, Babs.
Oh, can't you just take me home?
Couldn't we, Harold? We could just take her home.
They said you'll be finished by 3. We'll be back at 1:45. We'll take you home then. Out.
You can wash your own sodding car on Sunday.
Yeah. Yeah, stock number 72 and 79, rolls 148, 149. Mm-hmm. Sparkle on the rushes. Well, it's either dirty note or a faulty bat?
I don't know. You tell me.
It's 148 and 149.
Excuse me, can you help me? Excuse me. Which is the first assistant director?
In there. The one scoffing 4 black puddings. Death.
Are you the first assistant?
Not if you've got a problem.
I'm Babs Carter.
Yes, I know.
I'm doing the nude scene?
Yes, I know.
Well, I'm not now.
Not what?
Doing it. I think I'm sickening for something.
Not me, all sweet. I'll have some breakfast. Keep off the black pudding, Zoe. They've gone off.
Do you do greasy bacon?
We specialise in it.
Right, when it's my turn, I'll have greasy bacon, greasy egg and 4 black puddings, please.
You what?
Are you in it? This telly bollocks.
No.
Name?
Gilbert Dean.
Stuntmanning, are you, Gilbert?
No. Well, in a way, perhaps. I'm the writer.
Oh, I'm the writer.
Wait, can you get us on Big Brother?
Down. Ex-dictator, slightly less than a man, 5 letters ending in N. If 9 across is right.
No.
What sort of series?
Play siren. On a telly. What's the names in it? Solving stuff.
Oh, there. That's rubbish, isn't it?
What isn't?
Last thoughts, Dennis?
Cost me over 300 quid, that fishing rod.
You can claim.
Oh, I'll claim.
In which case, let's give it a go.
OK, that's a rehearsal, please, everyone. Supporting artists over there for the moment. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ladies. Thank you. Lionel, into the police car. Amanda, Michael, first positions, please. Thank you.
If that's OK with you, Amanda.
Yeah, of course.
OK, and stand by. Action then, folks. People crossing, car pulls up.
Just call it feminine intuition, Chief Inspector.
Where's the body?
In the front seat. He's the driver.
Was, I think you mean, Doctor.
And that's where we cut.
And we've cut it there. And
it's fantastic. Another little gem.
Think about a hospital porter.
Oh, bugger, sorry. There's more. Bloody writers!
Have I missed anything?
Oh, Christ, he's here again. Does he ever have a lie-in? Banquo's sodding ghost. No, Gilbert, you've missed nothing. Only breakfast. We're just rehearsing. All your little pearls are still in their oysters.
And what will you open them with? Your usual sledgehammer. Only joking.
Me too. Right, hospital porter, what's his name?
Mr. McGill.
Ready when you are, Mr. McGill. Where is the old fart?
Yeah, me here. Here, Phil. Joe McGill.
Fine, you start from over there.
Good morning.
Morning. As soon as Miss Holden approaches the ambulance...
Yeah, it's a pleasure to have the pleasure of working with you, Mr. Parrish.
Jeff, that's when you do your dialogue with Michael, OK? Right. And that's your mark there.
Yeah, certainly.
Go on, then. Yeah.
Is the camera going?
It's a rehearsal.
Oh, fair enough. Morning to you, sir.
Morning.
It's a privilege to have the privilege of working with you.
Oh. All right.
And you too, Miss Holden.
Thank you.
An honour.
And action.
I've never seen the young man in my life before.
I speak first, don't I, Phil? Sorry, yeah, right. Yeah, after he speaks. All right.
Sorry.
Again, then, your line, Michael.
Pal of yours, was he?
I've never seen the young man in my life before, and I've worked here 40 years. What was that all right for interpretation? A bit wooden, perhaps. Was it? Next time, I'll try.
Thank you,
and get it more,
thank you, sir. As he crosses, we thank you, sir. Then we tighten on Michael for his bemused reaction. Bemused, right, according to the script. Well, gospel, not script. Gospel according to St. Gilbert.
Bemused it is.
Okay, then, Dad.
Okay. Okay.
Right, let joy be unconfined.
Right. Ready.
Incidentally, mate, they're not right at all.
Who?
They're not real enough.
Who?
First and second gossiping housewives. They look too much like extras.
They're not them. They're just two housewives who happen to be gossiping. They're the extras.
Yeah, well, as long as they look real.
OK, car for Miss Holden and Michael. Bruno, back to basement wardrobe and makeup.
Amanda, thank you, that's fine.
Everyone else, clear the set for lighting.
Name. He's been in something.
Every man to his trade, eh?
Is it a married man? A married woman? I suppose we can rule out married hermaphrodites. Oh dear, that was supposed to make you smile. Didn't really work all that well though, did it?
See that half-dead one there? He's in charge.
Fancies himself, does he?
Thinks he's God.
OK, let there be light. Right, here we go. Nice and bright, everyone.
Gangway, potential BAFTA winner coming through. Excuse me.
Okay, first positions, please, everyone.
Oh, just
you are. Thank you, Lionel. Okay, lady. And we'll lock it off, please.
stand by. And quiet everywhere, please. And turn over.
Sound running.
Dennis?
Fine.
Mark it.
How about you're just in, Colin?
No.
Perfection.
Mark it.
Hang on, Den.
How about?
What's that in Michael's pants?
Michael has a foreign body in his pants.
I should be so lucky.
What's in your pocket, Michael?
Oh, just a crossword. Sorry, gang.
Still running.
Dennis?
Yep. We're running.
Mark it.
11:37, take one.
And action!
Just call it feminine intuition, Chief Inspector. Where's the body?
In the front seat. He's the driver.
Was, I think you mean, Doctor.
Pal of yours, was he?
I've never seen the young man in my life before.
Amanda, you fancy a quickie?
He looks all right, wanker.
Get your tits out for the lads. Get your tits out, get your tits out. Get your tits out for the lads.
Can't
get
your tits
out for the lads.
We're an actor, you know. Give us a bar.
I had a very unhappy childhood, Geoffrey. I'd now like it to end.
Public street, I'm afraid. People are allowed.
They're bloody yobs, not people. Who are they?
I don't know. Well, in a way, I do. I think they're what's known in the trade as your audience.
Well, for God's sake, sort them out.
Oh, yes?
Get rid of them.
Right.
Reason with them.
I see.
Ted, Bruno, show them your muscles.
Me?
Every
Deirdre, get Miss Carter ready right away.
Will do. Can I speak to him? Well, if he's not there, where is he?
Coming up any minute. You've got to go to wardrobe, get stripped off, and put on a dressing gown to keep warm.
Oh, the thing is, you see, I've got this migraine as well, and stomach cramps.
Well, just get to wardrobe.
And I wondered if someone could give me a sick note and send me home.
I'll tell the nurse too.
Oh, no.
Just as soon as you've done your scene, all right?
Oh, no. Phil, Amanda's coming.
Look,
can I ask you something? Let me talk to them.
I wouldn't have you sully your tongue, darling.
I'm going to talk to them, Phil, not lick them.
It's a free bloody country, mate. We pay our council tax.
We bloody don't. Look. Oh,
hello,
darling. Hey. Strippers
here. What's your name?
How do you mean?
I'm Amanda Holden.
Yeah, I know.
He's young Mal. He's old fella's Mal, so he's young Mal.
All right, OK. Pleased to meet you, young Mal.
Looking for a bit of rough, are you?
Get them off then, darling, I'm here.
Would you like a job?
I'm on the social.
OK, on the side.
I've already got three on the side.
Not for money.
What do I have to do?
Official crowd controller.
What?
Like a proper member of crew. You're in charge. Oh, Mr. Big. Any unruly elements disrupting filming, you show Moose Boss. By force, if necessary.
Do I get an armband? One saying official crowd controller sort of thing. Also, unruly elements suss it. You know, call it, or else. Force if necessary, right?
OK.
Yeah, bloody hundreds of them. All stood round doing sod all. Except for the ones sat on their arse doing sod all. No wonder the licence fee goes up. No, I don't think David Jason's even in it. Pauline Quirk, neither. It's peculiar, that, isn't it? You'd think one of them could be. Perhaps they're on holiday.
OK, we're going again.
Stand by.
OK, mate, carry on. Do it. Finger out.
And turn over. Sound running.
Camera!
Mark it.
11:37, take two.
And action!
Just call it feminine intuition, Chief Superintendent. Where's the body?
The front seat, in actual fact. He's the driver.
Was, I think you mean, Doctor.
Sorry, Phil. Cut it.
What for?
There's a cable in shot, and my hand slipped, and Amanda got the line wrong.
She got the line right. Always does. Ignore him, darling. You were perfect.
Well, my hand slipped and there's a cable in shot.
Cut.
Jesus.
Anyway, it was Michael who got the line wrong.
Did he?
Yeah. He said, in the front seat, in actual fact, he's the driver.
That's what you bloody wrote.
Not the words, in actual fact.
Does it matter?
Well, obviously.
Why, obviously?
It makes the line five syllables longer.
It means the same.
It ruins the rhythm, serves no purpose, and it's padding. Apart from that, it's marvellous.
Michael, elbow in actual fact.
What?
Apparently, you apparently said in actual fact. Apparently, it's a hanging offence. Apparently.
I've never said in actual fact in my life.
Well, he did then.
OK, settle down, everyone. Going again. Back in the car, please, Amanda. Sorry about that.
No, seriously. Very, very sorry, Amanda.
First positions. Stand by. Quiet everywhere.
They include you, sods, OK?
They've ripped me bleeding chest.
All quiet this end, Jeff, baby.
Jesus.
Turn over.
Running.
Dennis.
Yeah.
Mark it.
11:37, take three.
Action!
An intuition, Chief Inspector.
Sorry, Phil.
Now what? What?
Listen.
What to?
Aircraft.
Where?
Have we cut or what?
What do you mean, aircraft?
Like big iron bird from great land in sky. An aircraft.
What bloody aircraft? Sorry, Dennis, cut.
Shh.
Well, I know I'm clogged up with Qatar.
Listen.
There's nothing bloody up there, except God, and I'm not all that sure about him this morning. OK. Stand by till it's gone.
It's funny you never heard the other 53.
Boeing 747.
BA or Aer Lingus?
Lufthansa.
All right, mate.
I'm only doing my job.
Me too, in actual fact. All right, if I say in actual fact, is it?
Okay.
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 Again then, please. Fast as we can. First positions.
Big black cloud coming over, Phil.
Even faster then.
Okay.
Turn over.
Running.
Dennis.
Yeah.
Okay, a bit of hush. Mark it.
11:37, take four.
We're gonna lose it, Phil.
Action!
Is that rain?
Dry off. Get dressed again.
Dressed again?
Jeff just called. They're not ready for you yet. Going to the monsoon.
Which means if Bugalugs leaves to go to BBC Two, the Channel 4 job will be up for grabs.
Which is where you step in, right?
No, wrong. Which is where Mike steps in, leaving the ITV job up for grabs.
Ah, got it. So you go for the ITV job?
No, Roland, try and keep up. Bagalance goes to BBC Two, Mike to Channel Four, Stephen leaves BBC One, and, wait for it,
you land BBC One.
Television politics. It's never wheels within wheels, Roland. It's wheels within wheels within wheels. You'll learn that.
Coming down the booth there.
Can't, can I? I'm busy filming.
Such a cunning voice.
Managing to keep busy, I see.
Diana, it's panic stations all of a sudden. They're taking an early lunch.
Rained off, right?
Six frozen chickens, dozen tins of lobster bisque and a leg of lamb under the tarpaulin, all boxed up and ready for you, Roland. On the house.
Cheers, mate.
Well, he's the producer, isn't he? Producer's picks. So we get hired for his next film. How do you think we get on this one?
And that's the latest. An official statement that he's not leaving Channel 4. Right. All right. That means he definitely is. Thanks, Barbara.
Early lunch, Elliot. Rained off.
Good. You've organised the stills photographer. A few shots of me with the lovely Amanda.
Of course.
Good man.
Thank you, Elliot.
So if it's still pissing down after lunch, we scrub 23 and do interior bedroom?
Scene 44, the nude scene. So that's the art department and props finishing off interior bedroom during lunch. Sorry about that.
If it clears up, we'll knock this one off sharpish.
One of the hazards of the job here, Phil, at Mr. Parish.
Sorry?
The weather and technical itches, aeroplanes and so forth.
What about it?
No, just remarking. One of the hazards of the job here. Profession, that is.
Early lunch, everyone! Back in 1 hour exactly!
15 minutes!
1 hour exactly!
Hazards of the job stuff. None of this morning's been your fault, and it'll go marvellously after lunch. You're a good director. Very good.
I know that, Kelly. Very, very good.
You're not just saying that.
What do you mean? Are you just saying that?
Not too much.
Yes, mate.
Cod and chips and spag bol, please, mate. Same plate'll do.
Can't make up his mind, can it?
What?
With the weather.
Thanks, mate.
So what can I get you?
Vegetarian hot pot, please.
Any chips for your veg?
I'll have a few chips.
Next.
Cotton chips, mate.
Nothing on water?
Not yet.
Nothing of scene 23?
Not yet.
None of it?
Not yet.
You've shot the master shot, must have.
Tell him not yet. I can't say it again. My brain's chucked.
So what the hell have you been doing?
Sunbathing.
Phil, the schedule says another 6 days. You'll never finish it.
We'll finish it. We'll finish it.
Oh, for God's sake, tell Elliot that it is going well.
He's a network executive. Lies don't fool him. He lies for a living.
Thank you, young man. Morning, Will.
Phil.
Oh, sorry.
Morning, Phil.
Morning, Elliot.
How's the day going?
Marvellous.
Up to schedule?
Well ahead.
Good man.
Yep.
Should we get you some lunch, Mr. Nichols?
I think the young runner's organising it.
Brilliant.
Does anything you want, just to ask?
Getting on all right with him?
Fine.
Just want you to be happy.
Yeah.
Would you like me to fire him or anything?
Why would I want you to do that?
Well, I'm just saying, if you do, consider it done. Be back flogging the big issue in Piccadilly by 3 o'clock.
Cheers, Brian.
You're welcome.
Bruno! You know cows?
Cows?
Yeah, big things. Four legs, one in each corner. Stand in fields a lot and moo.
Yeah.
Yeah, what they don't do is stand in fields a lot and swim. The things that swim are called fish. This, pea brain, is fish. Cows are a completely different kettle of... are completely different!
Yeah, they said what with it being an early lunch, they'd no time to do your steak.
Yeah, well... just in case you ever go fishing and try and reel in a cow. It's one of those days.
You want to try my job, mate? They're all one of those days. So tell me... again, why have you shot nothing all morning?
Oh, I've got one of them.
Good, aren't I?
Yeah. Going
to be a cameraman then, are you? Not bothering with being happy, you know.
Well, thought I'd, you know, take a few pictures while I'm here.
Next.
Show me grandchildren.
You're who?
No, I mean one day sort of thing. Well, in case they don't believe that I was in show business.
Dennis?
Spotted Dick.
Custard?
No.
Here's my suggestion, and this is my final suggestion. Don't tell me he's doing rewrites. A writer doing rewrites without a Catherine wheel up his ass, I usually have to go on bended knees to change a bloody syllable. Ask him to change and to button his legs go.
It's his diary.
What diary?
For The Guardian. Arts page. It's, sort of, well, diary of what it's like on a shoot.
Christ, about us?
About everyone.
Find out what he's saying about us. When he goes for his pudding, get me one and nobble him. Now, good girl, find out.
Or Spotted Dick, darling?
Just debating.
Hi.
Oh, Kelly, while I've got you, keep an eye on their dialogue, love. You know how some actors try and make it up as they go along and how some directors let them. When I say some...
I always do, Gilbert. How's your diary going?
OK.
Anything nice about me in it?
Don't think there's anything nice about anybody. I seem to come out of it all right.
Good.
So then, will you love this true story? I had to limp on my right leg for Emmerdale on the Wednesday.
Oh, I haven't done an Emmerdale yet.
I don't know why. Then I had to limp on my left leg for a commercial on the Thursday. I've been up for 3 commercials, didn't get them though. And then, wait for it, this is absolutely true, I had to hop for EastEnders on the Friday. It's unbelievable. Hop. Acting, I had cramp.
I've never worked for the BBC hierarchy. Don't know what I've done to offend them.
Excuse me, Gov.
Yes, Ted.
Can I have a word about my film idea now?
Ted, I'm in conference with our producer.
Does that mean it's a good time or a bad one?
Give me 10 minutes.
Cheers.
Sorry.
You may choke on your spotted dick when you hear this, but I think we all have to start being nice to Gilbert.
That's something they never teach you at film school.
Got room for a little one?
Bloody hell. Certainly. Shove up, Kelly.
One steak, medium rare.
Cheers. So, you're all happy? Our lovely leading ladies happy? Where have I gone wrong?
Deirdre?
Yes, Bruno.
Just a question.
The answer's almost certainly no, isn't it, Bruno?
Do you fancy a drink after work?
No, Bruno.
Why not?
Bruno, I'm engaged.
Previously engaged sort of thing?
Previously engaged to be married sort of thing.
I don't really mean have a drink. I really mean have sex.
Yes, Bruno, I know. Amazingly, the answer's still no.
Check.
Now, focus group report. A, dialogue often too prissy. Spice it up a bit. More swear. B, Amanda Holden's skirt.
Sorry, skirt, it's a regulation police skirt.
Exactly. Shorten it a bit. Then, whenever we see her get out of the car, I suggest a low-angle shot.
It is a good idea. Get a flash of thigh.
Yeah, not bad. Make a note, Kelly. See if we can try it in scene 23.
See, they're a bit bored with the chief inspector. Shall we kill him off? Or is he a pal of Amanda's? Ask her, Roland. If she okays it, we do it. D. Tricky.
Hi.
Hi.
So, just a thought. Do you fancy a drink in here after work, when Judy's gone home?
I don't drink, Bruno.
Yeah, well, I didn't mean a drink, really.
Didn't you, Bruno?
Do you mind if I sit here?
I'd love you to.
Really?
Ciao.
Hello, love. It's me. Lunch break. Vegetarian hot pot followed by chocolate sponge. Choice of custard or cream. I went for the cream. Oh, very well indeed. It's going to be a belting little scene when we've done it. No, not yet, no. Technical hitches beyond our control. Bye then, love. Don't lift nothing heavy.
Can I have your autograph, please?
Oh, crikey. First today. To Betty, to Shirley?
Deborah.
To Deborah, best wishes. The show must go on. Joe McGill.
Who?
Oh, you're lucky catching me today, really. It's my only day on this particular epic.
Sort of a guest star, like?
Yeah, that sort of thing. For me sins. There you go.
Thank you.
Hospital Porter was played by Joe McGill. Joe McGill is a National Theatre player. Joe McGill is a member of the Royal Shakespeare Company. Joe McGill is now appearing in Uncle Vanya at the Haymarket Theatre, London. I've never seen the young man in my life before, and I've worked here 40 years.
So basically, the idea is there's these two brothers, right?
Police or detectives?
What?
Are they coppers or private eyes?
Well, neither, you see. It's a story about the way...
Hang on, you've got two lead characters.
Yeah, twin brothers.
And they're neither police or...
Are they doctors, then?
Civil engineers. Basically.
Ted, it's a TV series, right? And it's not about police or hospitals or... Oi! Bugger off!
It's no good for the BBC, then.
You're on slightly shaky ground here, son. Who play the brothers?
Oh, do you mean?
What actors are you proposing?
Actors? I don't know. I haven't really thought about actors. But the brothers' characters...
Ted, love. With respect, sod the characters. What you have to...
The whole story revolves...
Sod the story. Who are the stars? The big names?
That's the bottom line. You want to get a series on TV, one, get your stars. Two, make it about police, detectives or doctors, OK?
And
these twin brothers, Ted, which one's gay?
They've got girlfriends.
Are they in the police?
No.
And one of them's gay?
No.
It's no good for Channel 4, then.
So, hang on, let me get my head round this. Who's shagging who? Is one of the brothers shagging the other brother's bird?
No, there is no shagging.
No good for ITV, then.
Or the BBC.
Or Channel 4.
Or 5.
See, the brothers are building this bridge, right, so...
Oh, I better go. Busy. I hope that's helped.
You see, the thing about this bridge is, right, that...
Ted, TV is quizzes, or cooking, or gardening, or DIY, or drama. And drama is either handcuffs or stethoscopes, not about building bridges. Your idea's a bit too avant-garde.
And you'll still need stars, detectives and doctors.
And shagging.
Never underestimate the intelligence of the viewing public.
OK, a little bit of quiet, please.
And mark up.
11:37, take 5.
And this is the one, folks, for Definite. And action!
Just call it feminine intuition, Chief Inspector. Sorry, Phil. I've forgotten my line. Doesn't seem possible, does it?
And cut!
It's no problem, Amanda. Easily done. No problem at all. Absolutely no problem.
Where's the body? Yeah, of course. Thanks, Billy.
Starting positions again, then, please. Going right away.
Sorry, everyone.
No need to apologise, darling. We're only human.
This time, then. Like I said, for death or not.
Reset. Take 6.
Definitely for
definite. Camera.
Mark it.
11:37, take 6.
And action!
Welcome to the silk purse out of a sow's ear factory. Scene 44, body makeup.
The thing is, I probably won't be doing the scene owing to this raging toothache. I've spoken to the nurse.
Don't you upset yourself, dear. The camera won't be licking your teeth. Now, you had a session yesterday with Miranda at the beauticians, yes?
Yes.
Legs, armpits, bikini line, all waxed, yes? Good. Sue, dear, leave our golden tresses for a sec while we check for blemishes.
What blemishes?
Dressing gown off, please.
I haven't got any blemishes.
Bra off, please.
The thing is, I feel a bit sick.
Shading, yes?
Oh, yes.
What shading?
In the cleavage, dear, to accentuate the boobs a bit. Make them seem a touch more of a B cup.
They are a B cup.
One is, yes. Now, panties off and give us a twirl.
What?
Check if there's any cellulite, being cheeky, if you follow me. Quick ball. Wait till you're on set, dear. Naked as nature intended. You'll feel better then.
Roland, simmer down. You're so highly strung. Well, take six was NG because...
Lighting problem.
Because one of the lamps blew halfway through. Take seven because...
Bright sunlight.
Because we had to wait 3/4 of an hour for cloud cover. Take eight because...
Dead ambulance driver.
Because the dead ambulance driver was outside the ambulance having a fag instead of inside the ambulance being dead. Take nine was NG
costume
because...
problem.
Because Michael spilt coffee all over himself. 25 minutes to be sponged down, dried and ironed in wardrobe. These things happen, Roland. It's a glamorous profession. Don't worry, Roland. This time, then we're on to scene 44. Gilbert? No, not yet. I'll tell him later. I'll tell him. I'll tell him. Roland, put your feet on your desk and go back to sleep. It was a joke. I'm joking, for Christ's sake.
Okay, settle down, everyone. Final check. Doing it this time. Straight through, no mistakes, no planes, no gremlins, no English weather, no problem.
Heaven, timing's bloody football.
Absolute quiet.
Let me do it, all right? Shut your faces or I'll shut the bastards for you.
And turn over.
Running.
Dennis?
Yeah?
Mark it.
11:37, take 9.
10.
Take 10.
And action!
Just call it feminine intuition, Chief Inspector. Where's the body?
In the front seat. He's the driver.
Was, I think you mean, Doctor.
Pal of yours, was he?
I've never seen the young man in my life before, and I've worked here 40 years.
And cut! Terrific! Perfect! Well done, everybody! Well bloody done! Amanda, brilliant! Okay, for you, Dennis.
Checking the gates. Good for me.
Are we happy bunnies or are we happy bunnies? Yes. Gilbert, good for you.
Very good.
Happy bunny.
Very.
Was there any chance of looking at it for once? Like honouring us with a smile, perhaps? Like opening your mouth without snarling through the bugger? 3 choruses of hallelujah and a gruesome Mars bars.
But don't eat them all at once. Oh, well, that's life, isn't it, I suppose.
What is?
Here.
Where?
In the gate.
Oh, bells. Bloody bells.
The shot's no good, you see. Not with a hair in the gate. That's like a hair or a bit of fluff behind the camera lens. That's what it means.
I know what it means.
Still, we've done it perfect once. We can again. Are we downhearted?
OK, stand by, everyone. We're going again. First positions. Ready, Phil? Phil?
We got it. We bloody...
You want to try growing bonsai trees, mate? Ask my mother-in-law. Or fishing without a fishing rod. Come on.
Quiet everywhere!
That means you bastards, all right?
And turn over.
Running.
Dennis.
Yeah.
Mark it.
11:37, take 11.
And cut. Sorry. Action. No. Sorry. Yeah, that's right. Action.
Just call it fit.
Have we scheduled an earthquake? Jeff, what are those kids doing out of school?
You said they wouldn't be supposed to be on scene 44 by now, Phil, for God's sake!
That's him! He's the main one!
Get Bruno! Get them back! Don't hit them!
They'll sue!
Don't hit them!
Hit them! Hit them, little sods!
Hello? It's a cherry picker driver.
Oh, hi.
I'm sorry about this, but I think I might have missed the signpost for the unit base. I seem to be coming into the village itself.
No, no, listen. Don't do that, whatever you do. They're shooting there. The best bet is if you go back to the T-junction and then... Hello? Hello? Bruno? Bruno?
Feminine intuition, Chief Inspector. Where's the body?
Front seat. He's the driver.
Was, I think.
Jesus bloody...
What? God! What the bloody hell are you doing, you stupid great tart? Can't you see I'm trying to make a film down here? What is it? You want to be in show business,
stupid
bloody arsehole? What do you mean you didn't...
No, oh, him, yeah, we know. No, yeah, he just buggered up a take. Listen, while you're there, I was thinking, sometimes people can add spice to a jaded relationship if they have a one-night stand on the side. Yeah, so I was thinking, Hello?
Deirdre, tell Miss Carter to get her clothes back on.
Oh, God. I fell asleep putting my socks on this morning. I sat on the bed to put my socks on. And the next thing I knew, I was...
Why is she on the verge of tears all the time?
Who? Oh, is she?
All the time.
Perhaps she's training to be a director.
Sorry, we're going to need full afternoon tea now.
Now?
Sandwiches, sticky buns, tea, coffee and fruit juices.
For the whole crew?
Yeah.
Full afternoon tea?
Yeah.
It's another hour before we're
sorry,
scheduled to make...
they want it brought forward. Shooting's been held up. There's not going to be time later. Sorry.
Bloody hellfire!
Alison, I've been meaning to ask you. Instead of you making meals all the time, would there be a chance of me taking you out for a pizza after work?
Would there be an ulterior motive?
Yes.
No.
Thought not.
Ex-dictator, slightly less than a man.
Wrong.
Like person, but without the S. A person's a man.
Right. That's right. I was going to say Peron earlier.
So, that's the plan, assuming we get that away before Christmas?
We shoot scene 44 after this, then the cherry picker shot.
We'll probably have lost the light by then. We'll have to do it tomorrow.
We haven't got the bloody thing tomorrow. It'll only take 2 minutes. All right, maybe three. Oh.
Are you having a little tantrum?
It's like pins and needles down my leg.
Circulation.
It'll be nothing.
It'll be circulation.
The scene 44's no problem. The nude scene. Closed set, minimum crew, two simple setups.
Jeff, tell William Shakespeare I'm on him.
I told him.
I'm here. I prefer it when you call me Barbara Cartland.
Quick word, sweetheart. Roland wants some, rewrites for Friday. Don't panic. Nothing big, small-ish. Scene 85. When she says blah, 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 and he says blah, 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 we need...
Odd that. I don't recall writing blah, blah, blah. My computer must have crashed.
Give me a bloody break. Roland wants you to take a look at it. He thinks it doesn't quite flow. Him, not me.
Well, if the actor's ever read the stage directions, or you did...
And he, wants you to slip in a bit of, swearing.
Sorry?
The dialogue needs gingering up, and that's him, not me. We have our audience to think of. The younger end, Roland thinks.
The audience want effing and blinding?
Not every sentence. In moderation, perhaps just slip in the odd, oh, shit, or cute ass or something, just to show we're not dinosaurs, he says.
Does he now? One for the diary, that, I think.
Running.
Dennis.
Yeah.
Mark it.
11:37, take 13.
Action.
Let's call it feminine intuition, Chief Inspector. Where's the body?
In the front seat. He's the driver.
Was, I think you mean, Doctor.
Pal of yours, was he?
I've never seen the young man in my life before.
Again, Jimmy, don't stress the word young. Keep running. Say it again.
I've never seen the young man...
Don't stress young. It sounds as if you have seen the old man before, and there isn't one. Keep running.
I've never seen the... I've never seen the young man in my...
I've never seen the young man in my life before.
I've never seen the young man in my life before.
Life before? Emphasize life.
I've never seen...
Again, keep running.
I've never seen the young man in my
life... You're stressing young again.
Well, I've never seen him ever before, really. Well, in my life, I haven't... No, I'm sorry, no. Sorry.
Shall I cut? Again.
I've never seen the young man in my life before, and I've worked here 40 years.
And cut. So we're on the cloud. Jesus!
Was it okay for camera, Dennis?
Yeah, it's fine.
And me.
Printing it then, are we, Phil? Take 13?
It's the most crucial scene in the film. What did you say your name was again? Jimmy what?
Joe McGill.
That, Mr. McGill, was the most pathetic, disgusting performance in the annals of acting history. Congratulations.
Yes. I wasn't entirely satisfied with my delivery, really.
Weren't you?
Not entirely. A bit stilted.
It was stilted, incomprehensible, and the biggest bloody mess I've ever seen in my bloody life. And I feel as if I've worked here 40 sodding years.
Excuse me, can I have a word? Bloody hell, Phil. I know it's not my place, but all you have to do is re-voice him in the dub. There's no need of the poor bugger going over.
Right.
Yeah,
absolutely. We'll re-voice him in the dub, no question. But you're all right, are you?
Me? Jesus, Phil.
So how is it?
It's fine. Do you want to do it again?
Never again. Clean gate.
Yeah.
On to scene 44.
Okay, everyone, scene 44. That's a change of costume for Amanda and Michael. A wrap for the supporting artist and Mr. McGill. Great, thank you very much, and back to unit base. Fast as we can! Go, go, go! Bruno, tell Miss Carter to get undressed and on set right away.
Mr. Parrish. Sir.
Yes, Mr. McGill.
Couldn't we give it another go? I've read the whole script. It's a scene of prime importance to the understanding of it.
Why didn't you get it right then?
We've had to do it over and over all day.
That's what you paid for.
We're not machines. We're not cameras.
You had one line to do, Mr. McGill. One. And you couldn't.
It was a 13th take.
All the more reason.
I did the others okay. One or two of them were your... No, not your.
Do you know why you couldn't do it? Because you're no good. And that's why you're an extra. A stupid, lousy extra. Useless old bugger.
Yeah, okay, Phil.
okay. He's living proof of what you say about actors. Always, non-stop.
Yep. Enough, though. No need to upset him.
No? So which matters most? Sparing his feelings or saving the bloody film? Him or your script that took you months to write, as you're always telling us, and him 2 minutes to kill stone dead? Which matters most?
You don't know me. You know nothing about me, whether I'm stupid or no good or anything. You've only met me today. I've had thousands of days before today. I might be a very interesting person, for all you know. I might have been acting since before you left school. I might have once been in a cafe when an IRA bomb got chucked in. I might have brought up three kids. One of them might have been to college and got a 2-1.
Jesus, you also might have buggered up a day's filming.
This isn't real life, lad. It's pretend. It's all pretend. You're pretending. The old damn fool film's pretending.
Real life is how well we pretend, isn't it, sir? You, me, everybody in the world. Perhaps we'll try and find the best bits from what you did and glue them together. No one will know. It'll be all right on the night, as they say.
Locking yourself in all this time. It's that other people need to use the loo as well. Jeff?
Yes, Deirdre?
The nurse reckons it's nerves and gave her a beta blocker. Judy in makeup reckons it's nerves and gave her a pep talk, and I'm certain it's nerves. I gave her my last licorice all sort.
Hang on,
he's on the bed. She's standing here. He goes blah, blah, blah. As it were. Amanda appears in the doorway. She clocks what's happening. Then we do the reverse. That's it. A doddle. As it were. Again.
Phil, she might not be standing there, the nude. She says she's not feeling
Jeff, right. Believe me. If I have to staple her to the floorboard, she'll be standing there, I promise you.
It might just be an attack.
Tell her to get her ugly mug round here, then get her kicks off and think of BAFTA, all right? No argument! Otherwise, her career's over. And yours, and no doubt mine. Oh, bloody hell.
Deirdre, as soon as Michael and Amanda's done their costume change, shovel Miss Carter in the minibus and get her over here fast. Tell her she doesn't have to be naked, all right? Of course I'm lying. I'm a first assistant.
Completely bollock naked.
For artistic reasons.
Should I be in there, perhaps? To, well, you know, keep everybody quiet.
It's minimum crew. There won't be anyone to make a noise.
Oh, right. Well, if I'm, like, you know, sort of needed, I don't mind. Thanks.
Kelly, I was just surmising. You know your husband?
I do. Very well.
Doesn't he feel lonely when you're away working?
No. He's got his football on Sky. And if it's not on Sky, it's on ITV. And if it's not on ITV, it's on BBC. So that only leaves him about 4 minutes a week to feel lonely.
Right, it's just, I was surmising. If you're ever, like, lonely and need a friend to chat to or have sex with or anything, I...
Nice try. Subtle.
Hard luck.
Just an inquiry.
Bruno? No. A word of advice about girls from one who is one. You don't ask them for sex up front.
You do.
You don't.
They do on the telly all the time, in every episode of everything. It's like, good morning, pleased to meet you. Fancy a quick shag? Certainly, I'll just get my knickers off.
Yeah. Well, perhaps he should get out more.
My eyelid's been doing a lot of twitching for nothing, then.
Oh, what twitching?
Thinking of you being completely in the... unclothed.
Well, you can tell it to stop twitching. I'm not doing it naked now.
You're not?
You're not? Oh, Babs, that's marvellous.
Ready to go, Babs?
That'll take the smile off their faces.
Whose faces?
Well, people's.
What people?
Well, neighbours and that.
What smile?
You know, seeing you a figure and that.
What figure?
All right, you two.
Miss Carter.
Well, you know what you're like from the back in trousers.
No. What am I like, Mother?
Well, you're always saying you've got a big bum.
No, it's you that's always saying I've got a big bum. Or fat arse, as you usually put it.
Once, in the kitchen, Christmas, when you wouldn't move it out of the way and the turkey was burning.
Well, fine. Your eyelid can drop off altogether now.
What do you mean? What does she mean?
Excuse me, gentlemen and lady.
Oh, Babs, listen, I know in an off moment I inadvertently...
Well, that's what I wanted to talk about.
Babs, baby, I've had a slightly rough day, so I'd be...
Phil, if she doesn't want to be naked,
What's
then...
What's happened to you?
There is such a thing as compromise.
No, there isn't.
Babs, shush. We can shoot this, what we call in the trade, wittily. You don't have to be completely naked. You can be partially...
No. Completely. I insist on being completely naked as per my contract.
Fine. Good.
Will you be shooting my fat ass?
Well.
Well, you can if you like. In close up.
Hang on. Evita Peron isn't a man at all.
Her husband was.
Oh. All right. Now, I was thinking of the musical.
May I just take this opportunity of saying cheerio?
Yeah. Right, cheerio, then.
It's been a pleasure working with you both. An experience.
Thank you. You too, Mr. McGill. And don't worry about Phil. You'll be very good in the scene.
Oh, thank you, Miss Holden. You will too. Mark my words.
Michael and Miss Holden, please. Rehearsal. Into the minibus, please, Mr. McGill.
Yeah, will do. Excuse me, love. Just wanted to say goodbye and good luck. Perhaps it won't look so bad when it's, you know, all stuck together.
No, I'm sure it won't. Anyway, I'd better...
Oh, yes, I'll just bid a fond farewell to Phil, then, and the crew.
Actually, it's a bit cramped in there. They're just setting up. They're all like sardines in tomato. Oh,
fair enough. Not to worry. I'll drop him a line. Will you tell him good luck with the rest of the filming from me?
Of course. I must go.
Yeah, right. Well, see you on his next production. Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed.
I'll say so long, then, and thank you for your efficiency and courtesy.
You what?
Miss Holden thinks it might turn out passable in the end, scene 23.
All right.
Ready when you are, Mr. McGill. Quiet, everywhere! Turning over!
Notice me
me sneeze in my scene?
Yours?
Ours. I sneezed in it for added realism.
I think it went okay, really, didn't it, the scene?
They didn't ask me to, but I felt it needed it artistically.
I mean, a few technical problems, granted, but it could be a little cracker when it's got the music on.
Well, I had to scratch my ear once in Pride and Prejudice. Has anyone seen my camcorder?
I mean, with music and sound effects and that, it'll probably be a real... And cut!
And we cut it there.
Bit under the arm, was it?
Mine!
No, I don't mean literally. I mean...
Was I a bit slow on the...
Just a touch. Print it, one take parish, that's me. Well done, everyone. Smashing. Amanda. More than smashing. Absolutely. Perfect, as always. Cherry picker shot, right?
Tomorrow, Phil. Since they cocked up the afternoon, they've agreed to give us 2 hours tomorrow. No charge. I'll just call. Where's my phone? I can't find my phone.
Oh, dear.
Well, it's a wrap.
It's a wrap, everyone. End of a perfect day.
Home time.
I can't find my phone.
It's,
Thanks. Panic over. Well, my whole life flashed before my... Still, all right now.
Oh, hot bath. Bit of fiery Jack on this bugger.
Fancy a quick tea, Maria, do you? I'm not after a bit of leg over or anything. Just a drink. It doesn't have to be a tea, Maria.
I've waited 15 weeks and 3 days for you to ask that.
Have you?
Is it all right if we have a bit of leg over instead of the tea, Maria?
Do I smell kippers?
You do.
Good girl.
How does it go?
3 guesses.
You do it.
You just do. Professionalism, really. A touch of double toil and trouble at first, but I think it'll be marvellous when it's on. I've never seen the young man in my life before, and I've worked here 40 years. Bingo. We'll rent a new telly for when it's on. Widescreen.
I'm going to cut the hospital porter completely, elbow it all together.
You can revoice him?
Can, won't.
I thought you said the scene was crucial.
We'll put the same information in another scene. In reported speech, no hospital porter.
But wasn't it Gilbert's whole intention?
Whose intention?
Well, he wrote it.
What's that got to do with it?
Sorry, slip of the tongue. Okay.
Oh, yes, three times I've worked with Vinnie. Vinnie Jones, scholar and a gentleman. He used to play football for Wimbledon, you know. A lovely man. Lovely, lovely man. Sensitive.
Is there anyone you haven't worked with, Henry?
Sylvester Stallone.
Sly? Now you're talking. You know what I think Sylvester is deep down?
No.
A scholar and a gentleman and a prince among men.
Really? Have you worked with him then?
Of course. He played the Cockney lavatory attendant in EastEnders. It's the best thing he's ever done. Will you be driving me tomorrow?
If you put a good word in for me.
Oh, right. That's worth knowing. Thank you, Henry. Night-night.
You had it up to here with his verbals. Everything went pear-shaped. You reckoned he'd lost the plot, you lost your bottle, and wanted him sorted. Now, you can forget good cop, bad cop. What I do is bad cop. Very bad cop.
Crap, honey!
Feminine intuition, Chief Inspector. Where's the body?
In the front seat. He's the driver.
Was, I think you mean, Doctor.
Pal of yours, was he?
So, he wasn't a real ambulance driver at all. The hospital porter said he'd never seen him in his life before. And he'd worked there 40 years.
Where was your... Where was your...
Oh, well. That's show business.
Cup of tea and a Jaffa cake, dear.
Drama, innit?